My name is Amy Tran, and I am this year's UC San Diego BSA's co-ICC, as well as this Vietnamese Culture Night's executive producer and tonight's MC. Chúng em xin chào đón quý vị quan khách đến tham dự đêm văn hóa lần thứ 26 của Hội sinh viên Việt Nam tại UC San Diego, với chủ đề là Trở lại quá khứ. Chúng em rất hân hạnh cảm ơn quý vị đã dành thời gian để đến tham dự chương trình tối nay. I would like to formally welcome you all to UCSD VSA's 26th annual Vietnamese Culture Night, History Repeats Itself. We are so excited and honored that you all have taken the time to join us this evening. Trước khi bắt đầu chương trình tối nay, xin quý vị vui lòng tắt điện thoại di động và mời đứng lên làm lễ chào quốc kỳ quốc gia Việt Nam và Hoa Kỳ. Before we get started, please make sure your cell phones are off and on silent. We would also like to invite you to stand for the Vietnamese and the American national anthems. Lễ chào quốc kỳ quốc gia Việt Nam, the Vietnamese national anthem. Sau đây là phút bạc niệm để tưởng nhớ những tiền nhân đã có công dựng nước và giữ nước, đến các anh hùng liệt sĩ đã có công bảo toàn lãnh thổ lãnh hải Việt Nam, các chiến sĩ và đồng bào đã hy sinh bỏ mình vì lý tưởng tự do. A moment of silence to commemorate our ancestors ancestors who have built and fought for the nation, our armed service men and women and civilians who have lost their lives for the ideal of freedom. Phúc bạc niệm, bạc đạo. A moment of silence begins. The moment of silence has ended. Please be seated. Để bắt đầu chương trình tối nay, em xin mời đồng chủ tịch Nguyễn Phương Grace và Trương An lên sân khấu để nói vài lời. As the night begins, we would like to start the program with a word from our presidents. Please welcome Grace Nguyen and Anne Trung.
Welcome, everyone, to our 26th annual Vietnamese Culture Night. My name is Anne Trung.
And my name is Grace Nguyen.
And we are the co-presidents of the Vietnamese Student Association, IQC San Diego.
Chúng em xin chào đón quý vị đến tham dự Đêm Văn hóa Việt Nam lần thứ 26. Tên em là Nguyễn Phương Grace.
Và tên em là Trương An.
Và chúng em là đồng chủ tịch của Hội sinh viên Việt Nam tại UC San Diego.
We are so excited to be bringing back this tradition and proudly present our first Vietnamese Culture Night since 2019. This production exhibits what our organization strives to stand for, which is strengthening our bond as a community while we explore and reconnect with our Vietnamese heritage. Even though it has been anything but easy, we are extremely...
What are you wearing? Where's your white dress shirt or a tie?
Mom, you don't have to keep doing this for me. I'm 23. I know how to dress up for an interview.
You're 23 with no girlfriend. I think you might be doing something wrong.
You two bought me these clothes. They look like they came off a clearance rack. Colors that no one wants in a size bigger than I am.
Well, they did, and you'll grow into them. You'll be able to afford better clothes when you get this job. For what company again? Google?
No, Mom, Facebook. I swear, I've told you this like a million times already.
I'll use Facebook for their online marketplace to sell Tip Nung. When you get that job, could you hack into it later and help me sell more?
Wait, people actually sell food off of there? I thought you sold it at the Bami shop. Like,
my friend told me about it. Tax free. Pretty good.
Whatever, just... Please stop acting like I have the job already. I still need to get through this interview first.
Don't say that. Try your best, okay? Here's your bun
mate. I use premium meat for that one. Only the best for my son. So you do your best, okay?
Yeah. Just do my best. Just like every other interview.
Oh.
Thanks for coming. Casey Luong? Do we have a Casey Long Luong up there?
Yeah, that's me.
Come, have a seat in here.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. Usually there's a panel of people here, but as you know, with everyone working from home, we only have so many people here at once. So I get you all to myself. Starting with the basic information, birthday is March 6th, who is UC San Diego, bachelor's in computer science?
Yep, that's correct.
Your school, no football team still last I heard. So I guess you didn't have too much fun in college, huh? And it looks like you've only worked at a Tai-Sing?
It's Tai-Sing.
Right. But it also looks like you have no professional experience?
Well, although I haven't had a previous software engineer role before, I had to get classes.
Son, you literally have a computer science degree. I know. But have you done anything outside of your classes to show me?
Well, I did do that. No, wait, that was for a class project. Oh, I did make like a blackjack simulator before, but that's about it.
Gambling problem?
No, but I'm a fast learner. One time, my mom taught me how to make the sandwich, and I was able to make it just like her, like the second try.
Okay, why don't you tell me where you see yourself in 5 years?
Where do I see myself in 5 years? Well, ideally, I'd like to pursue a career here at Facebook. You know, it'd be nice to... No, wait, sorry. Let me try again on that question. Okay. In 5 years, I see myself pursuing a career here at Facebook. Equipped through the experience that this job has given me, I would work my way up the ladder to a senior position. All I want to do is to give back to my family, the people who have supported me the most. So, yeah, that's where I see myself in 5 years. Work in a higher position to support my family.
Okay, well, as much as I would love to offer you the position on sentiment alone, Mr. Luong, I'm afraid you're just not qualified.
I'm sorry?
Well, look at it from our perspective, Mr. Luong. We are in the business of hiring professionals. And you don't seem to have any professional experience. We simply cannot put our trust in you. You don't have what it takes.
Thank you for the opportunity, Dan.
Thanks for coming.
How did it go?
I didn't get the job.
Again? What happened this time?
I don't know. I think my interviewer was racist or something.
Every time it's a different excuse. There's obviously something wrong if every company rejects you.
I tried my best and I failed. It was all I could do.
Well, maybe your best isn't good enough. I think you need to ask for help.
You know, Gong Woo-Johom works at Google right now. She makes a lot of money taking naps in pods. You should talk to her and get some advice.
What? No, I'm not going to do that. I can find a job by myself.
Look where that's gotten you. I want to believe you can do it, but you've only worked at boba shops. Pouring sugar and tapioca balls into cups isn't a real job, Kong.
I needed the money to get through college. You know that. I couldn't just sit there and wait to be rejected by every internship.
Other people didn't have that problem. They're doing so well. You need to change.
It's not like I can go back to the past and change everything I already did. I slam my face into code and applications every day to make up for it. Some would say yes eventually.
But we're running out of time. We're getting old and wrinkly.
I can't keep working two jobs forever. When will you grow up?
You know, you two compare me to people all the time. My jobs are real, but you've been working the same low-precision jobs your entire life! I'm your son!
Hey, that's not fair. We started with nothing.
You're being very unfair. I had to deal with all this by myself while everyone else is a doctor or engineer parents. You didn't know anything!
You're being ungrateful! Do not blame us for your failures!
Oh, so am I just a failure to you then?
That's not what he said.
It might as well have been. This failure is going to his room.
Pineapples for you. Make sure you eat it, okay? I'll leave it on the counter.
Sometimes, when I wake up, I can't bring myself to get out of bed. I just stare at the ceiling. There are days where I don't even get to see the sun. What is it to look forward to? Another day of rejection letters? Another day of disappointment? Projects that never end up being any good? Probably because I'm not any good. I'm so tired. 2 years down the drain. 2 years and I'm not anything special, like an engineer or technician. I suppose I am a failure, a waste of a life.
You're a lot more depressing and dramatic than I thought you'd be.
Whoa, who is that?
Can you hear me, guys?
Oh my God. Jiu-Yu-Soo, is that you? God, please, I'm sorry for what I've done. Please, I don't want to die a virgin. No, that's your mom.
Okay, there's just a lot of things to unpack just now. If I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure mental health services are pretty accessible in the 2020s. You should think about some therapy, you know, and the stigma and all.
Whoa, wait. Who are you? How'd you get in here? Are you some kind of stalker? Should I be terrified or excited?
Anyways, I'm just gonna whoop over that. I'm Trit, nice to meet you. And no need for any introduction on your part. I know your name is Casey.
Answer me, baby dangerous stalker.
I'm what you say. From the future. Ooh.
I presently don't want to talk to you anymore.
Okay, wait. Okay. In all real talk, I'm here to save you from a horrible fate. You see, a fate where your
jobless, joyless, especially girlfriendless, babe. Okay? Come on, let me show you.
Is that me?
It will be in 50 years.
He looks so miserable. What happened to him?
Let's take a look.
Where did everyone go? I'm so alone. I'm such a disappointment. I'm sorry, Matt.
Sorry, Matt.
So, I just end up alone and miserable for the rest of my life? I'm so confused.
Well, it seems here that you do have a family, so that's a good thing, right?
Okay, thank God, that's a relief.
Ooh, actually, reading more into it, they all kind of left you. It's a little awkward.
Wait. What?
You see, the reason why I'm here is your bloodline has been plagued by a curse for thousands of years. Just generations upon generations, you know?
I don't believe in curses.
He doesn't believe in curses, guys. So you think I just spontaneously materialized into your bedroom, took you to see a vision of your future? But no, all that's real, but the curses part isn't. Curses
fine.
Are good, guys.
Fine. Go on.
You're, how should I say this, destined for a life of mediocrity. It's kind of blunt, but I just gotta say it like that. No matter what you do and what you say, you're just in an endless cycle of pain and suffering. Kind of tragic.
Okay, I get it. But why did you decide to go back in time to meet me? Why do you even care?
Think of me like a social worker, if you will. A social worker from the future. And it's just kind of what I do, you know? Help people out, get all the credit along the way. And as for why specifically you, Casey, it seems here that the curse gets really bad around this time. Just something about you just exudes really negative energy, you know?
Fine, so how do we fix this curse? What does your device say?
Actually, my device hasn't gone quite that far yet. Technology isn't really that great in the future just yet, but my genius brain has an idea though, so don't you worry, I have an idea.
The future blows. So, what's your plan then?
My genius idea is that we take you to the past to meet you, all your different ancestors, right? And we figure out what you guys have in common. And obviously, what you guys have in common will be what the curse is. And we can figure out what it is and we can break it. Easy enough, right?
Obviously.
I'm glad you agreed. Come on, let's go. We don't have much time.
When and where are we?
We are in the past in ancient Vietnam, where a prince, your ancestor, a prince, is here visiting a struggling village.
Prince? Ancient Vietnam? I guess this is where everything started going south. Wait. My V isn't very good.
Lucky for you, I happen to know that you, instead of going to Saturday Vietnamese school, you ended up playing League of Legends in the computer room.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't anticipate time traveling back to ancient Vietnam.
Well, lucky for you, I did. So, here's a translator for you.
Only one? You didn't bring two?
Well, I'm from the future, not rich. Those things are expensive, you know?
Fine, so what's the plan then?
It seems here that around this time, the prince's advisor mysteriously disappears. And I think that we can have you become his advisor.
So, do we just wait?
Yeah, let's go get change we don't stick out and sneak in the back while some of these villagers are reporting for him.
Thank you. nụ hồng trao đi, người mỉm cười đôi khi, những tư từ lâu nay cũng qua. Người đâu biết tình đắng, đời đâu biết mộng vắng, phố trường ngập đèn vàng buốt giá mưa răng. Đường xa đã mỏi gối, buồn yêu hắt mòn lối, tháng ngày chìm dần vào đêm tối. Nhưng người đã đến như ánh mặt trời, chiếu tia nắng rạng người, soi cho con tim ta.
Itchy.
God, all you do is complain and complain. You're so annoying. I actually kind of think you look nice in that. The other thing you made more made me look like my dad, you know?
Whatever, let's just find the prince so we can fix this stupid curse and go home.
Remember, you're the one with the translator. I can't say a thing. It's all up to you.
Hello, my prince. I am Casey Loon, your new advisor. And this is my illiterate, mute, and annoying servant, Trin.
Gasei? Ah, yes. I am Prince Zui, son of King Nam. My father's transport got stuck in a monsoon flooding, so I must lead today's meeting.
It's Casey. Anyways, I've heard many stories about you, my prince.
Stories? Stories about how I'm the most capable and fearless son of the king?
no. Stories about how you're scared and don't know what you're doing. You're afraid of living in your father's shadow and making nothing of yourself.
Preposterous! How can you know that?
Well, your father did hire me as an advisor after all.
Oh, it's true! I'm so scared. There's just so many duties that are king must uphold, and I still have so little experience. I was never a good pupil, you see.
Well, that's why I'm here to help. No, well, please excuse me for just a moment. What is it?
It seems like you got through to him. How did you do it?
Well, I figured if he was my ancestor, he'd be going through the same thing I was. Either that, or I think I just gaslight him.
Well, gaslit or not, I guess it worked. You're doing a really good job, actually. I'm kind of surprised. But anyways, it's all up to you now. I gotta go back to this time machine, okay? Good luck, have fun. Please don't die. It'd be really bad if you die.
Well, I guess it really is all up to me.
Two lords from neighboring provinces are coming today. But they always bicker, just like children. Here they come now.
My prince.
What troubles you two today?
His mother frequents the household of many men.
She does not.
She does too, and at night.
Well, your mother smells like manure.
I'll have you know, my mother smells delightful.
What should I do? They speak ill of each other's mothers, not of diplomacy. What do I do?
Just assert your authority on them. You're the prince. Show them that you are in control. Go on.
Silence! I, the prince, command you to conduct yourselves in a manner befitting lords of the kingdom.
Apologies, my prince. His citizens encroach upon my land, and they offer up nothing of taxes or compensation in return. How did he expect me to just lie down and peacefully concede all of my land?
Well, our harvest has been plentiful, and naturally, my people will seek to expand. We share our crops and fruits with you, and how dare you impede on our economic progress? Does your food taste sweeter when you harass your supplier?
Well, my no good supplier can taste the tip of my spear.
Not unless I give you a taste of mine first.
I think your lords have a lot more work to do than you think.
Please, advisor, what do you suggest I do?
You should get them to express their emotions. Where I'm from, everyone just hides their emotions in crazy names like. Get them to open up.
I stand a greater chance of success impaling my own head on a pike.
Do you have any other suggestions? You'd be surprised about what these macho types have to say.
I suppose I can trust you. You! How does your fellow lords in action make you feel?
How I feel, I've never, I feel a great compulsion to be vulnerable and communicative. At the time, I felt my authority was disrespected, and my trust betrayed. My village offers protection and services that I thought would be a useful compensation. I greatly value my fellow's resources. I don't want to lose him.
And you? Surely, you have feelings of your own.
The doors to my mind and soul have opened.
I don't think about it.
Our dynamic was more nuanced than I initially perceived. I apologize for my disrespect. My village has just become crowded, and my citizens feel comfortable expanding towards a province we do frequent business with. Our relationship is truly worth keeping.
My lord.
My lord.
Can you excuse him or something?
Lords of the kingdom, I, the prince, have masterfully resolved your conflict. Now, please, exit my view.
My prince. See, you did it. You can do anything you set your mind to, my prince.
And here I thought, my lack of experience would somehow burden my decision making.
No, that would be the curse on your family line.
For what?
Nothing.
I can't wait to tell Father that I And I resolved the conflict all on my own.
Yeah, I bet your dad would be really proud of you.
Really?
I mean, I'd be proud of a son who had the courage to speak his own mind, you know, do a little mediating.
Do you think that I could be a better king than my father?
I think you'd make a great king.
That isn't what I asked.
Why are you so obsessed with that question?
I proved myself capable, didn't I? That I am to be the successor to the throne? I cannot afford to be a mediocre ruler.
My prince, it is I, General Khoi. Where is King Nam? The situation is dire and require immediate action from the royal family.
Answer him. You're making military moves, not my prince.
I have been authorized to answer in his stead. What is General Khoi?
Very well. The Chinese plan to invade Halong Bay. Lieutenant Bao plans to construct spikes that are concealed by the high tide. This will destroy the enemy ships from underneath if they attempt to land. We only need approval from the royal family to utilize our resources.
Unfortunately, General, I do not approve.
My prince, what is your meaning?
This plan of yours, it is far too adventurous. The number of men and materials it would take would simply empty our stockpiles and coffers. Not to mention the time. For what? Such minimal gain? I will repeat again, General. I do not approve.
Your word is law, my prince. But I must say, you have grown into a fine young man. Nothing like when you were younger.
Explain yourself. What makes you say that?
Well, it never seemed that you were passionate about your kingly education. I thought you'd be more inspired by your father. I'm glad to see that I was wrong.
I am to be a greater king than my father, you know.
Of course, my prince. I take my leave. Thank you again.
You see that? I did that all on my own.
Yep. Yes, you did. It was very impressive, my prince.
And we must celebrate this feat with a feast fit for a king.
Go hard! I love your band! Yeah.
Eat up, eat up. You deserve to feast after all you've done.
Thanks, Louis. You know, it's a bit strange how you're presented with two major conflicts within such a short period of time, but I'm glad it worked out.
Something the matter?
Yeah, actually, something has been bothering me.
You've been a great deal of help to me, Casey. You can tell me. What's wrong?
Thanks, Wee. Your relationship with your father. Why do you want his approval so much?
My father? Is that all? It's just... he thrusts all these expectations onto me. Every interaction with him is just... another thing about being king. Geography, military tactics, even etiquette. It's just all so burdensome. How am I supposed to live up to someone as great as him?
Don't say that. I'm sure you'll make a great king. Someday, you might even surpass the likes of your father. Today was proof of that.
I just wish he was there, you know? Supporting me, guiding me. Like you were, Casey. How is it that someone like you is able to do all of that?
Back home, I never felt like I had anyone to talk to about my problems. I just kept it inside. So, see, you today stirred up something inside me. It gave me strength. So, I guess you could say we're kindred spirits.
I would have thought someone like you would have lived a very different life. Your confidence is contagious, you know.
Thanks, Lee. I wish you the best of luck on your journey to become a king.
And I wish you the best in whatever. Oh. One moment. I have some other matters to attend to.
Did you do it? Did you do it? Did you break the curse?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, he seemed pretty confident after I helped him out. I think he did a pretty good job.
Well, what are we waiting for? We don't have much time left in this time period, okay? We gotta go.
Yo, Trent, what you doing?
Well, as confident as you sounded earlier, I gotta do a little bit of quality assurance to make sure that you actually did your job.
Do we really need to? I mean, I think you did a pretty good job back there. I am a V. Doctor Who.
All right, V. Doctor Who, let's take a look at your future.
What? What happened? Why did my future change?
That's on you, Time Lord.
This can't be. He was ready to become a king. No, Trent, you gotta know something, right?
All right, just quit your nagging. Let me just figure out what happened. Okay, we should be taking a look at what happened after you left ancient Vietnam.
I'm sorry, Father. I didn't mean to.
Did you really think you could resolve everything with a wave of the hand? A flick of the wrist. The squabbling between the two lords is worse than ever.
You weren't here. I had to say something. The people were going to die.
You also made a major military decision without me. You're lucky I ran into General Koi in the hallway on the way here. I reversed your silly little decision and destroyed the entire Chinese fleet. For up to you, we'd all be dead.
Then what can I do? Will anything ever be good enough for you?
Results are not made overnight. You spent your entire life slacking off an ogling woman. Where did you get this
sudden,
foolish sense of confidence? You're useless, king.
I guess there you have it. You just did a little too much in too little time.
I don't understand how this could happen. How can you be so calm? This is another wasted effort. I tried my best and I failed, per usual.
Okay, just stop, calm down, okay? We have enough energy in the time machine for another try. Just let me think and we'll find another time period, okay? We got it.
You know what? No, I'm done. I'm done with this stupid time traveling nonsense. Bring me back to the present.
Hey! Don't touch my stuff, okay? This is delicate things we got here, okay? All you do is complain and complain. You can't just quit every time the first thing things get hard, okay? You have to keep trying. We have to keep trying.
You barely even know me. What kind of social worker are you? I demand to be sent back. I'll just fix the curse myself.
You're so ungrateful. Okay, I think I found the perfect one. And for your little outburst right there, add just a little bit of turbulence to your ride. Good luck, you're on your own. And remember, don't die.
Wait, Trin! Oh no, this isn't good.
Oh no. What happens if I evolve in the time machine?
Why do I keep randomly time traveling? I swear, I was only supposed to send Casey. Let's take a look at where I am. Great, I'm on the other side of the fourth wall again. It's always such a hassle to get back over, you know? Like, gotta jump the fence and like... So, anyways, I'm already here. I guess I might as well be the one to tell you the intermission is now starting. Feel free to stretch out your legs and walk around. Remember, restrooms are located in the mandible lobby, and please be back in your seats in 15 minutes. Ninjas! I guess I have to figure out a way to return my own. Wish me luck, you guys. Welcome back, everyone. I hope you guys were all able to stretch out your legs a little bit. As previously mentioned, UC San Diego VSA is a member of umbrella organization UVSA Southern California. As a member, we are able to collaborate with many universities across Southern California.
We have a couple of these constituent schools here in the audience today, and we would like to give a warm welcome to. First off, do we have CSU Fullerton?
Dominguez Hills in the house.
Including UVSA member schools, UC Irvine, UC Santa Maria. All right, let's give a warm round of applause to UCI.
Special shout out to UVSA Southern California for connecting all of these universities together. Do we have UVSA here tonight with us?
Here tonight. Whether you are in the audience or participants, we'd like to thank you guys for being here.
I will be teaching our chant here tonight and would love it if everyone would participate. Are you guys ready? Alright, so for our chant, I'm gonna start off with TRI and you guys are gonna say T-O-N. TRI? I'm gonna say, who are we? You guys are gonna say Tritons. Who are we?
Tritons.
Okay. I'm gonna say UC three times. You guys say SD three times. UC.
SD.
UC.
SD.
UC.
SD.
And then since we are Tritons, we're gonna go back underwater. Okay. Awesome. Are you guys ready? All right, here we go.
addition to our generous sponsors of our show. Thank you to our highest tier platinum sponsors. Thank you to UC San Diego Associated Students, the Union of Vietnamese Student Associations of Southern California, Delightful Cafe, Whole Foods Supermarket, Give Me Jewelry, UC San Diego Parents Foundation, Fuck Cal Cali, no! Kim Kwang Jewelry, Huai Huai Restaurant, PT Eatery, as well as UC San Diego Division of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. I would also like to shout out our gold sponsors. Thank you to Viet Pharmacy and Medical Supplies, Hui Ki Bakery, Trim's Family Hair Care, Vin Long Food To Go, and Pho Fusion. Lastly, we'd like to shout out our bronze sponsor, Pho Van. As a nonprofit organization, we rely on the generosity of the community in order to make this production possible. We here at UC San Diego VSA would like to formally thank every one of our sponsors for their benevolence and goodwill. Let's give them all our sponsors a big warm round of applause.
Strip mall? Toys R Us? Blockbuster? Oh, hi, excuse me?
Jennifer, I mean,
great, you're Viet. Sorry, G, can you answer me a really weird question?
Yeah, I'm, go ahead.
I need to know what year this is.
Oh, no. You're some homeless drug addict, aren't you? Please don't hurt me! I don't carry any money on me and...
Whoa, wait. Where'd you get that idea from?
Well, who doesn't know the year? And look at those pants! Look at those holes!
It's the new style. Sorry, that was a weird way to say it. Look, I just need to know what year this is. I haven't had a job in a while, and I can't remember the new year started. It all just seems like a blur.
Well, it's January 6th, 1997. But let's take care of your pants problem first. You can come in. I always keep a few back here just in case. So, how about this? Or this?
Cargo pants? I'm not a Boy Scout. No one even wears these anymore.
So, you're just gonna walk around these streets naked then?
I'm not naked. Look, I don't need a new pair of clothes, trust me. But I just have to ask, why did you decide to help me?
Well, because you're like me. Look, it's been a few months since I came here and I haven't met that many new Vietnamese people, so... I got really excited when I met you.
Oh, I see. Well, anyways, I gotta go. Thank you so much for your help once again.
Oh, wait, before you go, can I ask for a favor?
Yeah, I kinda have something else to do though.
Well, you said you don't have a job currently, right? So, what were you doing before?
Well, I wasted my time working at a couple tea shops and helping my parents make banh mi at a place like yours. Nothing impressive.
That's great! I mean, it hasn't worked out so perfectly before, but I'm pretty sure I can trust you since, well, you know.
Wait. You want me to work for you? I don't know. It just seems like a big commitment. And I don't know if I can live up to your standards.
Well, don't worry about it. And besides, you're gonna be better than any other person I've hired here.
You know what? Okay. Yeah, I can work for you. Just one last thing though. Can you take me to the nearest hotel? I kind of don't have a place to stay. I can't really get into it right now.
I knew it! I knew you were a homeless person! But, yes, yes, I'll take you. But before we go... Are you sure you don't want any new clothes?
Living in this big blue world.
May I? I have good news.
Trời đất ơi, làm tao giật mình. What is it, con?
I found someone to help me out at the shop.
Huh?
I said I found a young man to help me out at the shop.
Another one? Con, that's nothing special.
But it's different this time, man. He's going to be here. So no more putting ketchup and mustard on a sandwich like it's a hamburger.
I mean, if he does, I'll give him a good smack.
How long do you think you can keep him for? Well, I think I can keep him until Jung arrives.
It's been months. I think you need to think long term, Gong. If your husband is going to help you at the store, then I'll be the only one taking care of the baby. He needs his parents.
I know, ma'am.
You know, when you were a baby...
Oh, here it goes.
You were so scared of everything. We could barely bring you outside without you crying so loud. You destroyed my ears. But we still love you anyways. So much.
I'm pretty sure you're exaggerating that one, ma'am.
Wait, what did you say? Anyways, Gong, I trust that you'll make the right decision. Just be careful.
I will, ma'am. For you and for this precious little family I love so much. Oh, hey, Anne. You ready for your first day of work?
Yeah, I think so. Could you just let me know what I should expect before?
No time to waste. Here is a knife, here is the bread, here is the vegetables, here are the meat, and you are good to go, okay?
Wait. Don't you want me to make banh mi your way? What if I mess it up?
Well, you made banh mi with your parents before, right? So, relax. They won't tell the difference, but you definitely need to get started before the rush gets here.
Wait. The rush?
Yeah, you know, the line standing right behind you.
Hey, what's up?
That's a bit earlier than I expected.
Well, go on, take his order. Go on.
Hi, how can I help? How can I help?
The day's finally over. I thought I could trust you, Em. Did this happen before at your parents' banh mi shop? Did you lie to me?
No. It wasn't anything like that.
Okay, then what is it?
Recently, I've had a string of failures, and it's kind of why I'm walking around like a bum. I don't know if I can do anything anymore.
Well, listen, I got an adorable baby and a less than adorable mother to take care of, so I'm kind of low on options right now. But maybe I expected too much from you.
I'm surprised you expected anything at all.
Well, okay. Let's start with the basics this time. Can you make me a banh mi? Anything will do.
Yeah. Aren't you gonna taste it?
I don't have to. You make it about the same as I do.
Yeah, well, my parents made me practice a lot at their bunmi shop. It was basically free labor.
Well, you do know how to make a good bunmi. You take the time to distribute out all the ingredients, and you even put sriracha mayo on it. No one else I know does that.
Yeah, well, I figured if I just threw everything together, I probably wouldn't be able to sell something like that.
Isn't it the worst thing when you take a bite out of a sandwich and all you get is bread and cilantro?
Yeah, it's the worst, and everything good just pools up at the bottom.
Exactly! You need to take the time to make something you're proud of. Otherwise, how are other people going to be proud of you?
I'm sorry you didn't get to see any of that today.
Well, that's okay, because you're gonna try again tomorrow.
Wait, really? You mean it?
Well, you're kind of my only option right now, Em, so yes, I mean it. There's a letter from Joe. To Joe? That same ugly handwriting and that same ugly heart. I'm probably the only person in the world that could read this, and
That makes me feel really special. It's been months since we last saw each other, but it feels like years. I wish you could see my tiny little piece of America, my tiny little shop, our tiny little apartment, our tiny little baby. I can't wait for us to start the rest of our lives together. Well, plus my mother, of course. But after all this time, you're finally making your way over. I love you, Joan. She's still asleep, but I gotta get going, so. Good morning, Matt. It's time to wake up. Matt? 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 Matt?
Are we supposed to be prepping to open a shop today?
Oh, hi, Ann.
Is something the matter?
I was just coming to tell you that I can't open the shop today.
Why?
My mom passed away this morning.
Wow, I'm so sorry to hear that. You know, probably wouldn't want to go to work either. My mom passed away. You know, I could have just stayed at home and I would have gone and done something else.
My baby Long, he needs someone to take care of him and... Oh no. I can barely afford rent. I can barely afford to eat. I can barely afford to survive. So I can't miss a day of work because my husband, he's traveling thousands of miles of ocean and then he's just gonna come here and then there's gonna be nothing for him and...
Gee, stop, you're smiling, stop. Everything's gonna be okay.
How can you know that?
Because you're amazing. You managed to find the strength to show up to work today. You survived this long in America with just taking care of your mom and kid. That's how I know. You're a better person than I could ever be.
Well, that makes me feel a little bit better, but what am I supposed to do now?
Wait. Well, what if I ran a shop?
Do you recall what happened yesterday?
No. It's different this time. Trust me. I know how to make banh mi. You've seen me do it before. After yesterday, you made me realize that maybe I am good at something. Even if it's just making sandwiches.
Here are the keys, and here's the address you're gonna drop them off at, okay? Please don't make me regret this.
Hey, it's like what you said. I am indeed your only option. My hands are all sweaty. What am I doing? The customer's food's gonna be all salty? I'm so stupid. I need some gloves. Wait. How much money do I have in my pocket? Maybe I can tell her that business is about to close up shop early today. After all, I still need to find my ancestor in this era. Maybe. No. I'm tired of being a failure. I'm done running. I might not be able to make a difference in my life, but I can make a difference for this lady's life. That way, I can be someone that can make others proud. Alright, let's make some sandwiches. Hello, hungry patients. Your food awaits you. Oh my God, I did it. Only 7 more hours of this. World, get ready to meet your maker of sandwiches.
What a strange man.
Till then I fight, rain on me, put the blame on me. Got guilt, got hurt, got shame on me. Got 6 magazines that's aimed at me. Done every magazine was fame to me. It's a game to me with a bedroom mat. Sleep, I ain't never had a fast with that. What's fair when the hearts and the words don't reach? What's fair when the money don't take things back? It's rare when somebody take your dreams back. I care too much, wanna share too much. In my head too much, I shut down too. I ain't there too much, I'm a complex soul. They layered me up, then broke me down. And morality's dust, I lack in trust. This time around I trust myself. Please everybody else but myself. All those spells, I was myself. Outdone fear, outdone myself. This year you better won yourself. Mask on the babies, mask on the hot boy. Mask on the neighborhood, stores you shot. But a mask won't hide who are inside. Look around the reality, calm and lies. Wipe my ego, dodge my pride. Look myself in the mirror, how many felt? Ain't seen that scarier. I fought like a pure poor chariot. Blood I shed, could fill up aquariums. Tell all my angels carry on. Every emotion being deprived. Even my strong points couldn't survive. If I didn't learn to love myself, forgive myself 100 times down. I love when you count me out. 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 Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fucking it up.
Hey, G, look what I got.
A stroller? Thank you, and that's exactly what I needed. How was running the shop today?
It was great. I felt so in control. It definitely wasn't anything like the first time. I was spreading bread and sliding and meeting so quickly. Sorry, that was a bit weird.
Well, you remind me of my husband. He has a tendency to say the first thing on his mind. I think you could pass for him, actually.
Well, thank you. Your husband seems like a really good guy, and I hope I get to meet him someday.
Well, you're gonna be sticking around a little longer, right? Well, you will, and you'll be an amazing role model for little Long here.
Thank you, G, but I don't think you want that for your family.
Well, what makes you say that?
Throughout my whole life, I never felt like I was good enough for my parents. I was busy, scrambling to put the pieces of my life together. I felt worthless.
Well, Em, look at you. You ran an entire banmi shop by yourself today, and you went out of your way to help me, a stranger you've only known for a couple of days. And you're so compassionate, and you're so caring.
But I feel like my parents can't see that until I become the ideal son. I'll just be another screw-up to them. They won't acknowledge me.
Do you want to hold him?
Yeah. He's so tiny. How old is he?
He's 10 months. His birthday's in March.
Oh, but really? Well, mine too. What day?
March 6th. Is something the matter?
No. Nothing's the matter. I just thought it was funny that we had the same birthday, that's all. Gee, can I ask you a question? What if your son grows up to be a failure? Like, what? What if he struggles to find a job after school?
You know, when I look at my baby, I can't bring myself to think of any of that. All I can think about is how much I love him, I'm gonna take care of him, how much I'm gonna feed him. He could screw up a million times, and he'd still be my son.
I think that's how every mother feels.
Even if he was just like me?
Well, I'd be proud of him.
You're proud of me?
Well, of course. You're a fine young man. I'm sure your mom would be proud of you, too.
I'm sure she is too. Whoa, wait, what's happening? Well, I didn't expect to be here.
Sorry, Bessie, gotta get you out. I barely had enough time for to get us back here.
So, this means I can't see if I can my future got changed or not?
Nope. Sorry, Bessie.
Wait, what about my mom? How is she gonna survive without me? Will she wonder where I went?
Can you just think for like half a second? She was fine without you before, she'll be fine without you now. Like, she'll be fine.
I guess you're right. But wait, won't she remember stuff in the past now? Won't she freak out about who I am?
About that, I kind of have a little confession to make. Don't hate me, but this entire day today,
I kind of have the machine on safe mode, you know? Nothing you ever did today actually changed the past.
Wait. What? So, I did this all for nothing?
Not exactly for nothing. You will regain a very vague memory of what happened today. Like it was a dream, you know? Just a fun little dream you had. Yippee.
How do you know so much about me? So many questions.
Let's just say I can go ahead and tell you next time. Bye, we'll see you.
Oh my God, what happened? The prince? My mom? Where am I?
Here you go, Casey. Here's your mangoes.
Thanks, Mom. Oh, wait. Before you go, how long was I asleep for?
You slept for 5 minutes.
Oh, okay, thank God. That's a relief.
Is everything okay, Gong? You know you still have pineapples to eat, right?
Yeah, I'll eat anything. I'll eat anything you give me, Mom. Mom, I'm finally gonna do it. I'm gonna finish all those projects I've started. It's gonna take some time, but my God, Mom, I'm finally gonna get a job.
Well, I'm happy for you, Gong. Well, what's gone into you?
So, after I stormed into my room, there was a time traveler who told me that our family was plagued by a curse. And so, she said I was the only one who could stop it. And so I went back in time.
Uh-huh.
So there was a prince, a bunny shop, and a lot more dancing than I expected. But I learned so much.
What's going on here?
And there's my dad. Soon, you won't have to work two jobs anymore. And you can rest those old wrinkly hands of yours. I gotta get started.
Well, I'm proud of whatever you do.
And everything you do, girl.
Mom, Dad, thank you for being a part of my life. I'm gonna make you proud.
Mặc nhau ta nhìn nhau ta nhìn phố lâu sẽ bị rồi đây. Đôi khi ta không mua bài vì cảm thấy ta.
Morning, Kong.
What you doing right now?
I'm making bun me.
You need help with that?
Yeah, there's a knife over here. You know what to do. How'd you sleep?
Pretty well, actually. I just got back from my time traveling, and honestly, it gets pretty hard sometimes, you know? It's just really exhausting.
This isn't some sort of charity work, right? You aren't wasting your time. This is worth it in the end.
I would say so, yeah. I think being able to see all the people that I've helped really keeps you fulfilled in life, you know? Like, just seeing all those smiles on everyone's faces.
Okay.
So, what are you doing for the rest of the day?
Why are you asking?
Can I not know what my own father is doing for the rest of his day? Like, is that such a weird question to ask?
Okay.
Like, what?
Okay. Since you insist, once your lazy mother wakes up, me and her are gonna finish preparing this food, and then we're gonna visit your brother and his family. After that, me and her have some dinner plans at this nice restaurant with my friends. What are you doing for the rest of the day?
I think I'm just gonna stay home and just kind of have a chill day, you know? My last client, he was just so annoying. He just kept complaining, and then when he finished complaining, he started nagging. And then when he finished nagging, he started complaining again. Like, gosh, there's just too much to get into, you know?
Yeah, that guy sounds like he sucks.
It's funny that you say that.
Why?
He kind of reminds me of you, just a little bit, you know?
Okay, first of all, I'm nothing like that. And second of all, it's actually funny that you say that because when I was about your age, I had this strange dream where I time traveled to different periods. Kind of like what you did. And I helped all my ancestors. I don't know, I think I was pretty good at it. And then after that, I just became a whole new different person.
That's a really interesting dream you had there, huh? I wonder why was it so special to you?
I don't know, I just had this confidence in me. And look at me now. I'm successful, I have a wife, I have kids, and my daughter time travels for fun. Or work or whatever. Anyways, were you able to help your client?
I think that I was able to. But I honestly can't take all the credit, you know? I feel like throughout the time that we've been traveling, he was able to find something that he needed all along. Something in himself. And honestly, I think you turned out pretty well, if I do say so myself.
I'm gonna give a shot that chili shaker! Before I give my ending speech, I do want to give some special thanks. Thank you to Chris Tran. He's somewhere out there. I know that. Yeah, he's right there. He's right there. He helped me edit the script, so what you see here today was because of him. So thank you very much. I also like to thank Charles Stone. He made the beautiful door you saw there. It's so nice. I'd also like to thank our media team right here. Billy, Joanne, Ivy, William for taking pictures. Thank you so much. Capture the magic of BCN. Let's give a round of applause for them. And they're not here, but I would like to thank the UCSD Lion Dance team too. They did a great job, and I'm just happy they're here. All right. This is crazy. I've always dreamed of this doing in high school when I did it back in like sophomore year, and I tried doing it my junior year, and it's just it got shut down because of COVID, and I'm just really happy that, you know, my dream finally came true. I'm not gonna cry. There's a joke I said among people that rockets don't stop halfway because it's a really bumpy ride, but you know, we finally landed the rocket. We did it! And yeah, I'm just so grateful for everyone here. This wouldn't have happened with the help of everyone, and I'm really grateful for everyone here. So thank you guys. I'm just sweating from my eyes. I'm just sweating. And yeah, I just want to thank everyone here. We could put on a show, but the fact that you guys come out here and everything really means a lot to me. And yeah, that's all before I start crying.
On behalf of VSABCN, the entire group here, and the coordinators, we'd like to shout out our choreographers. So first we have Trad A, Nikki and Teresa.
Not least, the man, the myth, the legend himself, Larry, our VCN director!